Welcome back. Government, through the Ministry Regulation Number 118, year 2018, provide adjustment covers minimum service standards, tariff limit, and suspension implementation to create a healthy competition atmosphere. Government, through the Ministry of Transportation, planning to forbid the existence of discount tariff by online transportation operator. So to know better about what people think about the plan, reporter of IDX Channel, Clara Antawijaya, covered it up for you.
Thank you, Wiki Adrian, and good afternoon, viewers from Indonesia and Singapore, with me, Clara Antawijaya. Mobility is an ability to move from one place to another place, and technology makes us easier to book single trip by only single applications. It seems simple, easy, and win-win solutions, right? But actually, there are obstacles happens there, and mostly, it's about pricing. Government, through the Ministry Regulations Number 118 in 2018, stated the adjustment of online transportation tariff limit and also minimum service cost. But however, the Minister of Transportation, Budi Karya Sumadi, stated that he would like to request ban on discount for online transportations.
Kita minta tidak ada diskon-diskon. Diskon yang langsung maupun tidak langsung. Diskon yang langsung sudah relatif tidak ada. Yang sekarang ini ada diskon yang tidak langsung yang diberikan oleh partner-partnernya ya. Oleh karenanya kita sedang merancang satu permen atau surat edaran yang melarang diskon itu.
To be fair, I would like to ask opinion from the driver of online transportations. Let's go. Selamat siang, Pak.
Siang.
Iya Pak, saya mau bertanya terkait pendapat Bapak terkait pemerintah yang melarang diskon untuk ojek online.
Tentang diskon ya, menurut saya kalau diskon dihilangin, orderan bakalan menurun. Soalnya konsumen pasti bakalan beralih ke angkutan umum yang lebih murah. Pemerintah juga harusnya bikin kebijakan dong, naikin tarif yang senyamain tarif untuk angkutan yang non-online biar bisa bersaing, bukan malah menghancurkan yang udah lumayan lah bagi driver.
Kalau larangan diskon sih saya nggak setuju. Karena apa ya, saya juga merasa diuntungkan dong kalau ada diskon gitu kan. Otomatis kan saya lebih hemat, lebih murah gitu kan. Selama itu tidak membebankan konsumen, saya kira itu nggak masalah. Gitu.
Sudah baik, terima kasih ya Pak. Based on the conversations from the driver and also the user from online transportations, we can conclude that the non-discount from the government for the online transportations would be a burden from two sides, whether it's a user and the drivers. Go back to the studio with Wiki Adrian. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Clara. Different from yesterday's statement, the Ministry of Transportation through the Directorate General of Land Transportation affirmed that his side is not authorized in regulating discounts for online transportation. Even Directorate General of Land Transportation stated that discount regulation are given for authorized parties like OJK and Bank of Indonesia. According to Budi, regulation related to online transportation discount is out of Transportation Ministry's authority, but the role of the ministry is supposedly assigned to provide and secure online transportation business. The Ministry of Transportation through the Director General of Land Transportation plans for calling Online Transportation Association in discussing Ministry Regulation Number 12 and about tariff limit.
Nah, terkait diskon, jadi setelah saya komunikasi terus-menerus berapa hari ini secara intens, terutama dengan lembaga-lembaga yang memang menurut saya memang berkompeten dan memang menjadi kewenangannya, dapat saya simpulkan bahwa kita masih dalam rangka perumusan, tetapi secara umum bahwa regulasi yang sudah kita buat ini memang tidak mengatur menyangkut masalah diskon. Tetapi ternyata di dalam beberapa kita komunikasi dengan OJK, dengan BI, dengan KPPU, jadi kayaknya saya tidak perlu mengatur itu di dalam regulasi.